I have an idea for today's video. Let's do a subscriber highlight, shall we? Okay, you guys, so I am home. I'm not at the studio with the normal background. The cicadas are starting outside, man. But there's a follower of mine who's a fellow subscriber. His name is Tim Cotter, and his work is awesome. Every time I see it, I'm like, this is so cool. So I figured, let's do a subscriber spotlight. Maybe make this a thing. But in the meantime, we're gonna jump to the phone conversation while I show you the images, and we'll just kinda take it from there. So without further ado, Mr. Tim Cotter. Helicopters are way harder than a plane.
Somewhat. At first, they can be more challenging, but in the end, they're not that much different. There are some differences. Mostly, at airspeeds below about 50 knots, different.
Really?
Above that, they're quite similar.
That's interesting, minus the gliding part.
Well, helicopters can glide, but not worth a damn. They can glide short distances. You can land a helicopter even if it loses its engines, but there are advantages though, because a helicopter can land in very small areas compared to an airplane.
Yeah, that's how we're rolling tonight. So Tim, say hi to the world.
Hello to the YouTube world.
So Tim, everybody is looking at these images, and I'm sure they're thinking the same thing that I am. First of all, are you using a tripod, or are these things are absolutely handheld?
It's 100% handheld.
Wow, come on.
I've seen other photographers use monopods, tripods. However, I haven't used one. I need to buy one, a good one of these days, but everything I do is handheld.
That's amazing. And what state are you in again?
Alabama. Southeast Alabama.
That's wild. I honestly, right here in Louisiana, I'm like your neighbor, and I had no idea this amount of species are right in your neck of the woods.
There's quite a few just within a few miles of my home.
We have some bald eagles. Right, I live really close to the levee and the water, and every once in a while, one will nest, you know, kind of close. And man, when those birds take flight, I don't know how you don't stop and just appreciate what they are, because they're huge, you know. Their wingspan is big. And, of course, I never have a damn camera on me when these things are close to me taking flight. You, however, seem to get these images. For those that are looking at your images going, how does he do what he do? How does he get what he get? Just, you know, real quick, explain the process, like your mind process of, I'm going to take some pictures today. And like, what happens?
I pick up one of three Fujifilm bodies and one of four different lenses I mainly use. If I'm looking for birds, I use the 100 to 400 millimeter Fujifilm lens. Well, I have three bodies, X-T2, X-H1, and an X-T3. X-T2 and X-H1 focus really well in single focus, but the X-T3 focus is excellent in continuous autofocus. If I'm using the X-T3, I can use continuous autofocus for everything. Well, the X-T2 and X-H1, it works okay, but it's superior on the X-T3, I suppose, because of the better processors in it. The other lens I use the most probably is, or definitely is, the 80 millimeter macro, and I usually use it with a Fuji's 1.4 teleconverter. That gives me 112 millimeters at f4. That works well for insects.
Well, I was going to say, that's, you're still fairly close, though, to get that kind of macro.
Yes, I can get within a quarter of a meter is the minimum focusing distance. However, the teleconverter allows me to stand back a little bit, because if you get too close, most insects take off.
Right.
So I found that combination of the 80 millimeter and the 1.4 teleconverter works well.
Yeah.
As I said, I don't just walk up there and get an image instantly right. I take several images, and hopefully one or two of them is in focus, and one or two of them usually are in focus.
So, quick question for you. First things first, shutter and ISO, I'm not worried about. F-stop, what f-stop are you shooting? You mentioned before, I think you said it was an f4?
It's an f2.8. The 80 millimeter is an f2.8, but with the teleconverter, it makes it an f4.
Okay.
However, if there's plenty of light, I'll stop it down a couple stops to increase the depth of field.
Yeah, because you got this lizard with water droplets on his head.
Yeah.
That blew me away. I have never seen it before.
That was an f4 at about, I don't remember, 250th of a second or so, because it was really early in the morning. He was in the shadows, and there wasn't much light.
It looks awesome.
And on top of that, was a difficult shot, because I was standing in this really soft, muddy place, and I could hardly hold still. And as you know, when you're working in macro, your depth of field is razor thin.
Yeah.
So if I move the slightest bit, it throws the focus off.
That's what I'm saying. This is like ninja style photography, handheld, like for real.
It's taken me a while to work on it to get consistent results.
Yeah.
Some days I hold the camera steadier than others, but I guess I can hold it pretty steady. I've been able to do this so far without a tripod, as I mentioned.
You showing me that, you know, red-tailed hawk, or that amazing fly image head on with you, and you're telling me that was handheld. My brother, I have the ultimate respect for you, and I know you consider yourself an amateur photographer as if you're beneath others. I don't believe in a best. I think we all have moments of greatness, and you, sir, are being featured, because these are some really, really great images, and I'm proud of you. I just want the world to know who you are. Go follow this man on Instagram and just show some love.
I appreciate the kind words.
Absolutely. That's what we're here for, right? I mean, in my eyes, humans are supposed to uplift their friends and not keep everybody beneath them. I don't get it. I don't know why everybody needs to scratch and claw to the top, but they don't take anybody with them. Makes no sense. You know what I mean? So, Tim, I appreciate you, dude. And when you put an image up, I know you're just throwing one up on Instagram, and you may not get 100,000 likes and that kind of thing, but you have to know that somebody like me, who's been doing this for almost 25 years now professionally, is looking at your image going, damn, this is awesome. Like, I know the steps and the work that goes into getting this. I truly appreciate you being here, my friend.
Thank you for the invite and the kind words.
Not a problem.
I've never had any professional photographer make such a deal about my photography? As I said, it's a hobby for me. I suppose I could have made a living at it, but I've made my living in aviation.
Man, look, thank you so much for being here. I'm going to get back to you on the phone. I'm going to close out the recording. You got to go follow this man. The links are below. It's on the screen right now. And give him some love and absolutely let him know that you found him through Focus with GK right here on this YouTube channel. And I'll see you guys in the future.
Come on. How fly was that? How cool was that? I love it. I get inspired watching you create things that are worthy of sharing with people. You know what I mean? We see so many images that feel like copycats or nothing original. But do you have the patience and the talent to photograph little bitty creatures like he does? In action is just awesome. It is. So look, subscribe if you have not already. I thank you for all who have been here throughout my journey on YouTube. I do have some really cool things in the mix coming up soon. But the simple fact that Tim is also a Fuji boy, come on, man. That's awesome. Hit the like, do what you do. Tomorrow I'm going to the beach. My first getaway for the summer. It happens tomorrow. But I'll bring you guys along as well. Why not, right? Peace.